It was 2006 and I was sitting in my room, chilling on my computer. MSN was open and I was going through the hype machine. I don't remember what blog I discovered this song on, but it literally changed my life. Justice's remix of Simian's We Are Your Friends caused waves in the electronic music world. Justice, or Justice, two seemingly unknown artists, which at the time were graphic designers by trade, entered a remix contest and this was the result, a movement that spread like wildfire, bloghouse. Now it's definitely hard to pinpoint when exactly bloghouse started, but for me, it was when I first heard this song. Some argue it was between 2006 to 2011. Fact Mag says, producers making traction in the bedroom believe they could be the biggest act in the world if they managed to reach the top of the MP3 blog aggregator, the Hype Machine. As blogs race to post the biggest tracks first so they could get to the top of the charts themselves, the quality control levels drop to appallingly low levels. The abrasive bass and angular structure perfected by Justice were endlessly copied, resulting in club nights where DJs would play any old 128KB MP3 just to stay ahead of the curve, even if the music was basically unlistenable. By 2009, the pills were crap and the neon dreams and carefree days were over. Moving away from bloghouse's roots momentarily, I was always an electronic music fan, but We Are Your Friends opened new floodgates for me to find and listen to new songs on all the blogs I frequented. Hipster Runoff, Missing Tooth, Futuristic Silence, Disco Dust, Disco Bell, LA Friendly, Voulet Random, and ultimately I opened my own music blog sometime in 2008. WDPK 83.7 FM. With my new music blog live, I would find as much good music as I could, write something insightful about the artist, and spread the word with that sweet SEO optimization. Artists that wanted to be featured would reach out to me and ask me to blog about them. Being on someone's blog roll meant y'all were buddies, they trusted your taste in music, and had faith that their visitors would visit your blog and they'd find equally good music. From 2007 to 2015, it was like 80% electro, 15% indie rock, and 5% hip hop for me. Bloghouse to me was infectious. Frequently associated with words like electro clash, new rave, and new disco, the genre, which was a mixture of all types of sounds, didn't give a shit about conventions. It was party music along with being exploratory. Some even say bloghouse was like music's puberty. Jazz Shaw of Semi Mobile Disco says, "Bloghouse is what happened when people who ought to have been in bands spent more time in nightclubs than in venues. I went to countless shows and DJ sets to experience bloghouse firsthand. It was insanity and it was a subculture." In 2018, a lot of the prominent bloghouse artists are no longer active. On top of that, a lot of the blogs I used to follow are either shut down, bought out by bigger media companies, or simply no longer updating. We have Spotify, Apple Music, and SoundCloud. Today, music companies have a stronger hold on how music is discovered. I'll elaborate further later on in the video. Mars. Trends come and go. Bloghouse was like the flavor of the month that will last it close to 5 years. Mixmag's Jack Nedham states, "The music scene ebbs and flows. They become hyperbolic in an instant and then the bubble bursts equally as quickly." Additionally, a lot of Bloghouse's top artists were young and creating a shift online was good enough, and definitely at that time it was hard to top that. Herb states, "In the beginning, when you're seriously broke, you're looking forward. Everything is possible. You wake up thinking, today I can make something that will change my life. Every day I woke up thinking that, and it powered me through. Bloghouse wasn't sustainable, and as it continued to grow, it became boring because everyone was doing it." In addition to trends coming and going, artists grow out of their phase or their sound. Take for instance Love Fox from Can't Say They're So Sexy, or CSS, the band behind one of Bloghouse's biggest tracks, Let's Make Love and Listen to Death from Above. Love Fox is living a completely different life today. In 2015, she spent a month building earthships in developing areas of Argentina, and in 2013, she became a qualified hypnotherapist. When asked about the Bloghouse period, Love Fox responds fondly, "It was maybe the best time of my life. It was so much fun. We were just so silly and I missed that. There was a lightness in those days, but it just comes from the age and the time. Things are different now. It's a different kind of scenario."
Let me back up.
Discovering music is different now. What helped define Bloghouse wasn't just the style of music, but also the way music was discovered. There was MySpace and blogs, and pretty much that was it. And when you found a song that hit all the right notes, it was like finding gold. Then once you shared it on your blog, you developed proper blog credibility. A-trak explains, "What ties together a lot of Bloghouse is how we discovered it. It was a point in time where a lot of people's influences converged. there was an openness to what the sound really was. That type of openness is now controlled by apps like Spotify, Apple Music, Tidal, and SoundCloud. These apps make discovering new music as easy as a few swipes on your phone or tablet. They also incorporate algorithms to help you discover new music based on your current tastes, so they pretty much have us locked into their apps and ecosystems. Furthermore, major publications and social media influencers step in to decide what's cool and what's not, often relying on tips from an increasingly underground-minded coterie of publicists. The industry has established a firmer grip on distribution and promotion than they had between 2005 and 2010. There have been numerous rumblings about Bloghouse's resurgence, especially with artists like Uffy making a return, albeit a small one. I'm all for Uffy popping more Glocks in 2018, and I'm hopeful, but as Vice's Larry Fitzmaurice states, it's possible that some of the sonic attributes we associate with Bloghouse, clean melodic lines, rock-leaning song structures, Gaelic influences, will come back, but any genre revival is always bound to provoke cynical reactions, mostly due to the nature of revivals themselves. Why should we focus on the past when some of the best music and truest artistry turns its eyes towards envisioning a new future? Perhaps it's best to view Bloghouse as pure nostalgia, and enjoy it as such. I'll always look back fondly on Bloghouse. It really was the driving factor in my matured appreciation for music. I explored so many different feelings and emotions, both in front of my computer and at parties. What can give you those same feelings today? As music critic Megan Garvey confesses, looking back, it all feels so stupid and ironic, but at the same time I thought, this is what music is all about. Part of me truly fell in love with music through Bloghouse. I had never participated in music culture that was so all-encompassing. It made me feel so alive. Bloghouse was a feeling, and I hope this video has you feel some kind of ways.